I'm going to create a little tutorial here showing you how to do PhotoStory 3, and I'll show you some of the tips that I use. I've opened up PhotoStory 3, begin a new story. And before I did that, actually, I created a folder that would have my photos and my songs that I would use in the project. And so I have those saved in the folder. And then when I save my project, I'm going to save it into that folder too. So keep everything together when you're working, because you may not want to go back and edit it another time. So PhotoStory has an import pictures button. So I'm going to go look on the desktop here for my folder. And there's the flower photos I'm going to use. And I'm going to click in the white area and hit Control A, and that selects all. And then I'm going to click OK. There they go, coming in there. Now you need to know how many pictures you put in there. So when I look back in there and hit Control A again, I can see I've got 33 items, okay, 33 pictures. So the default time for each picture is 5 seconds. So if you multiply 5 seconds times 33, it equals 165 seconds. So that means you're going to have 2 minutes and 45 seconds with the default times, which you can adjust, but that kind of gives you a ballpark figure when you're starting at how much time per song or songs that you're going to have, depending on the length of your PhotoStory. So remember to use your calculator and time to help you out when you're doing that. This is the storyline. Now, you can't make the thing full screen. That's as big as it gets. It's a free program from Microsoft, so that's what you see is what you get. If you were going to come back and add more pictures in later, what it will do is it will put it to the end of the line. So I'm going to bring the first picture back in again as a second copy, and it puts it at the end of the line. To move it to the beginning of the slideshow, you grab it with the left button and hold on, and you drag it and you deposit where you want. So now I've got the bee with the magnifying glass on it. Two of them. Okay. Now the reason I like to do that is because in the next step after importing the photos, and it may ask you about black borders. That's something they ask for. Normally if it says do you want to remove black borders, I say no, do not remove the black borders. It'll normally be fine without that. So anyway, I'm selected on the first photo, and I can put some text in there. So I'm going to say flowers in Abilene. Okay, and you can change the font color and the size. So I could go in there and make it bigger, bold, and so now I've got that first slide. And so, you know, when we go to the next slide, then you'll see the picture without the text. So that's why I'll double the first photo for that very reason. Okay, so anyway, I'm going to go to the next step. Now this is the step where you'll do 99% of your time working on your project. It's called customized motion. And in customized motion, there's a lot of things you can do. You can look and see what this first window here shows, where the picture starts, and then this other one shows where it ends at the end of the time period, 5 seconds. So you can adjust the time on every picture. And since it's a title slide, I'm going to make it 7 seconds in length. And then I can also, you click up in here, and that allows you to edit the way the slide moves. So maybe I want to start like that. Maybe I want to end up with it full. So from 1 to 5 seconds, that 7 seconds, that's where it's going to move, from the shorter view into that. You save and go to the next picture. And so, see, I don't want it to end up looking like that. So you look at all of your pictures and make sure that you've adjusted them so that they don't look dumb looking when they're doing the pan and zoom. That's what you're looking at here, the pan and zoom. So you go through all your pictures and you fix all of those bad ones like that. So there's another one. Okay, so I'm going to save. And then here's another one. So that's another one I'd want to fix. Now, you don't always have to start out with the bigger picture on the left. You could change it and say, okay, on this one I want it to start way in on the honeybee, and then I want to zoom out. So you pick the transition that you want. You can also do things like make it move from the top left down to the top right. So through 5 seconds, 6 seconds actually, because when I did that, it made the default time get bigger. You're going to start looking at that, and then it's going to move on down into this area here where the butterfly is at. So I'm going to save. Another thing you frequently will do, if you have people especially, is you may do this effect here. You'll select it, and you'll start from the left or the right, and then you'll make the other side. So it's going to flow from left to right, or I could say let's flow from right to left. Anything you see in the gray area, the transparent area, that will not show up in the picture in the slideshow. So in effect, you're virtually cropping a photo without cropping it. So if you have something that's not a desirable feature in the photo, you can use this customized motion area to crop it out so that it will never show on the screen. So you don't have to go work with your photo to get rid of action like that. Things to watch out for are things to where maybe you've got people here and notice it's going to zoom on down towards the bottom part of their bodies. That's usually not a really good thing to do. So, you know, try to adjust those things so that they don't go down to areas that looks kind of dumb in your slideshow. So I'm not going to do all the rest of these. I would normally go through and fix every photo in the slideshow, but for this tutorial I'm going to move on to the next step. So once you've saved and done all of the photos, you do close and then hit the next button, and now it's asking for the music. So you start at the first slide and you go select music, and then I have a song here, Gentle Melody, and then I check and see it's going to be color coded. If you had more than one song, if you had a lot of slides, as you add a second, when it ends up, it'll be an empty space to the right of it, and then you would insert another song. So, and there's nothing that says you can't stop a song in the middle. So I could go like right here and add a second song, and then it will make that other one fade into the new song. So don't be restrained by the length of the songs. You can overwrite how much they play. You can have 2 minutes of a song, or you can have the entire song and whatever looks best. So this one has got all of the song in there. It's actually not going to finish all of the song, but it will fade out at the end. So now I'm ready to go to the next step, which is to produce the Windows Media Video file. I'm going to save my project first, and I'm going to say save, and I'm going to save it into the folder, and I'm going to call it Photo Story Flowers, and save it. And sometimes on a slow computer and with many, many photos, because you can have up to 300 photos in a photo story slideshow, that's the maximum, it could take 5 to 10 minutes doing a save and then also creating the final product here. Now here's the settings when you're getting ready to save. So I have used a lot of the different ones in here, like there's a profile to create the WMV file that says it's made for creating it a DVDs afterward, meaning you take the product and pull it into a program and then you can make a DVD that would play in a DVD player. But for computer files, and even for the ones that I have had experience doing, I usually pick number 3 or 4. The Profile 4 is a 1024 by 768 resolution. It looks really nice when you take Nero or Roxio and take the resulting Windows Media Video file and turn it into a DVD disc. So this is the one I use a lot. I may change my mind later on, but for right now that's what I'm doing. So I'm going to click OK, and then watch where you're saving it to. So I'm going to direct it to save into my folder where I have my project. So, and I'm going to call it the Flowers Movie. It's really a slideshow, but it will be a movie file. So I'm going to go save and then go next, and then here we go. And it's going to start, it's going to do 3 steps. It's going to prepare the video in the first step, and in the second step it's going to mix the audio. Now if you use WAV files, if you rip a file off a CD and get a huge WAV file, they will make for a better quality photo story, but it will be slower when you do this step here. And then the third step is it's generating the video. So it's going to, and notice that it's the product always from PhotoStory is a WMV file, and that stands for Windows Media Video. So it is a video file, it's a slideshow of the photos, and it will use those transitions that you, it'll use those motions that you did in custom animation. I don't do a lot of the special effects with the photos like you see, you can do that in PhotoStory. I usually do the special effects in PaintShop Pro ahead of time. Now it says, do you want to view your story? Usually at this point I just exit out of there and I go look in the folder where I saved it to. And there is my file. It's 98 megabytes, so pretty big file, but if it wasn't something that you didn't have copyright release for the people in it, you could put it up on YouTube, or even better, you could use something like usendit.com and give a link to just the participants that you did the slideshow if it were of people. So let's play it and see what it looks like. Oops, I'm sorry, I hit the project file. The project, and this is, a lot of people make this mistake and I just made it, the project file can be huge because it embeds all of the pictures and the sound in it. So that was the 98 meg. So actually the Flowers movie was not 98 meg, it was 18.5 megabytes. So that's not too bad. A little too big to send an email probably. Let's play it and see what it looks like. There we go. And watch, I remember I did just the first few slides, so we'll see. Now as I'm playing a media player, I'm gonna hit the Alt Enter key. And I'm going to move my mouse up away from the taskbar and off to the right. Now the bottom will go away. So there's that great pan zoom that Ken Burns used so well in the Civil War documentaries. And it is such a great feature in PhotoStory. So there's that side-to-side motion that I had in the, on the cactus. And then there's the zoom in. You want to have the highest quality photos that you can possibly find. The higher resolution, the better. The highest resolution you can use is a 7199 resolution. So if you have a big panoramic photo, you're going to have to scale it down to 7199, no larger. And there we go. Great little slideshow. We'll see you later.